With rich natural assets, a strategic geographic position, a young and well-educated population, and a demonstrated capacity for rapid recovery, Iran possesses many of the strengths needed to succeed in competitive global markets. In the past, these strengths have driven substantial development, including the creation of state-of-the-art value chains and levels of performance surpassing that of many regional competitors. In the present, these strengths underpin the potential for future trade-led growth. However, Iran's potential has been held back by serious external constraints to trade and international integration. These constraints compound domestic challenges regarding the business environment for smaller firms, productivity, the attraction of foreign investment, access to finance, and labor utilization.
در فرایند تدوین استراتژی ملی فعالین در حوزه مورد بررسی اهم از بخش دولتی و بخش خصوصی طرف مشورت کارشناسان مرکز تجارت بین الملل بودند و پیشنهادات حاصل در متن این اسناد ناشی از تعامل صمیمانه بین این سه بخش بوده 500 نیروی کارشناسی در بخش‌های خصوصی و در بخش دولتی همکاری کردند و همچنین با مشارکت کارشناسان خبره‌ای این کار انجام شد شناسایی خلأهایی که مانع از توسعه تجارت هست در اونجا و اینکه چه خدماتی رو باید به صادرکنندگان ارائه بدیم مد نظر هست تمرکز بر کمک به شرکت‌های کوچک و متوسط یا SMEs هست نگاه جامع به زنجیره فعالیت‌های مرتبط با توسعه صادرات مد نظر قرار گرفته بدون کمک مرکز تجارت بین‌الملل و همچنین کمک‌های اتحادیه اروپا این کار انجام نمی‌شد و جای تقدیر و تشکر داره از همکاری‌های فنی که در این زمینه با جمهوری اسلامی ایران داشتن
نزدیک به 350 فعالیت و اقدام در این مجموعه این اسناد تعیین شده بنا این هست که با کمک وزارتخونه‌های مرتبط بخش خصوصی زیرت در این حوزه و با هماهنگی و هدایت سازمان توسعه تجارت از تخصص بین المللی مرکز بین المللی تجارت و کارشناسان بین المللی استفاده بکنیم و در طول دست کم 3 سال اینها رو بتونیم همه این 350 اقدام رو به منصه ظهور و عمل برسونیم
ITC has had the privilege to be exposed to the wide spectrum of Iran's economic capacities, as well as its driving forces in the field of digital solution, tourism, agribusiness, light and heavier infrastructure. Having carried out product diagnostics, factory assessment, the international buyers we brought in, the market experts, are unanimous on Iran's untapped export potential. And even more so if we consider its geographical location, its demographic dividends, as well as its natural resources. Now, we do believe that there is a consensus on the fact that trade-led growth is not only possible, but is slowly becoming a necessity.
The potential of Iran as a tourism destination is promising as long as there is a strategy to diversify the different sectors, subsectors of the tourism industry. And in that sense, the strategy which was chosen by the NES to identify community-based tourism, ecotourism, health tourism, and also to make stronger the cultural and historical tourism is a right strategy in order to target different market segments.
Designed to navigate and respond to these complex issues, Iran's national export strategy is a 5-year plan to build a more resilient economy through trade. It will advance export diversification to create new opportunities for Iranians, in alignment with the 6-5-year National Development Plan and other national priorities. While not a panacea, this strategy would be an indispensable instrument for enhancing trade competitiveness by boosting productivity and sparking a process of reform.
این خیلی نکته مهمی است که ما به یک استراتژی و به یک نقطه نظر مشترک برسیم برای اینکه بتونیم محصولات و خدمات سخت افزاری و نرم افزاری رو تو بخش آی سی تی بتونیم مخصوصا به کشورهای همسایه صادرات انجام بدیم.
A series of consultations with senior representatives from the public sector, private sector and civil society were held from mid-2019 to early 2020 to define the scope and focus area of the strategy. Plans of action set out in the National Export Strategy provide details on specific activities to be carried out in order to help Iran to compete, connect and change, to compete on a regional and global level with other international suppliers in both quality and price, to connect with buyers in key target markets and establish strong business relationships, and to change by upgrading the production of strategic exports in Iran and by embracing innovation across the value chain. Through this strategy, stakeholders are given the opportunity to work to reverse worrying economic trends by improving trade and investment promotion to support diversification, bolstering quality management to increase export value, and strengthening entrepreneurship and skill development to leverage plurality. To boost trade performance, actions are to be prioritized on sectors with proven export potential. 6 priority sectors have been identified: fruits and vegetables, medicinal herbs, petrochemicals, auto parts, tourism, and information and communication technology.
So much of variety, such a wonderful quality of different products which we saw, you know, naturally comes to our mind why our customers in our countries don't get to see them in that quantity. So what we discussed today with the director of the market is extremely important, that they pay us, they find a solution, or we find a solution together on the logistics, so that the right time and cost is achieved in the process. Because when you are dealing in perishable products, there is a very simple rule: either you sell or it smells. So time is very important.
I think that many of the products have a good potential on the export market, but what needs to be taken care of is the packaging and marketing strategies. The packaging that is currently presented is good for industrial market, for B2B market, but won't really work for the retail sales.
The National Export Strategy has been made possible with funding from European Union under the EU Iran Trade Development Project and with technical assistance from International Trade Center, or ITC, a joint agency of the United Nations and World Trade Organization. The ITC supports developing and transition economies around the world in enhancing their competitiveness in and connectivity with international markets.
کشور ما یکی از کشورهای بسیار غنی از نظر تنوع ژنتیکی گیاهی هست و تا به حال حدود 2300 گونه گیاه دارویی تا فعلا شناخته شده که حدود 1728 گونه گیاه دارویی حالت انحصاری دارند و این نشون میده که کشور از نظر غنای گونه‌ای بسیار غنی هست. زمینه فراوری و در زمینه پکیجینگ و در زمینه‌های ضد عفونی کردن ما دچار مشکلات عدیده هستیم که داریم با ITC وارد جریان شدیم. قرار شده که ITC بیاد و یک سری تدوین دستورالعمل‌های مطابق با روز دنیا رو به ما بده. ما در سال گذشته حدود 570 میلیون دلار صادرات گیاهان دارویی داشتیم که گیاهان مهم ما در این امر زعفران بوده با 351 میلیون دلار و موسیر و پیاز میخوایم بگیم که 140 میلیون دلار و شیرین بیان 32 میلیون دلار و سایر اقلام گیاهان دارویی مثل گشنیز و زیره و سمغ‌های مختلف بوده که جمعاً 570 میلیون دلار رو تشکیل داده.
Each and every sector we work with has a unique value proposition. When we talk about medicinal herbs, it has 850 registered endemic plants and a 3,000-year-old traditional Persian medicine. Or when we talk about ecotourism and community-based tourism, these segments can count on local communities and a rich history and traditions. Or when finally we talk about the vibrant digital sector that has seen the development of a broad variety of high-quality digital and e-commerce platforms. This sector modernizes the entire country's operation while tapping into the young and educated population.
The National Expert Strategy brings together the perspective, experience and knowledge of a wide range of participants to decide on how to build on Iran's strengths, address the challenges the country faces and realize its expert potential. Stakeholders from across Iran and international partners are working together to achieve the strategy's vision of trade-led resilience made in Iran.